Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by the CEO of Magnetite Mines. It is Tim Dobson. Tim, a very warm welcome to you. And some big news out earlier today. You have updated your mineral resource estimate at the Iron Peak deposit. Perhaps you'd like to give us a quick summary.
Yeah, great. Thank you, Tom. Pleasure to be here. And a pleasure to talk about this release that we've made today. It's actually the culmination of a couple of years of hard work by the team. Iron Peak is one deposit in our wider Razorback Iron Ore Project. It was long ago observed that it had high grade, but it was quite a small deposit, and the company had been focusing on the much larger Razorback Ridge and Razorback West deposits, which are quite substantial in volume. However, a follow-up drilling campaign last year confirmed what had been observed by our geologists. This is in fact a much higher grade deposit than the wider Razorback deposits, and also is larger than we thought as well. So this has provided quite a significant shift, and in the release I refer to this as a turning point for the company. So what we have now is over half a billion tons in Iron Peak alone, but with a significantly higher grade than the rest of the Razorback project. Now, why is this important? Well, with very large projects, and in fact, any mining projects, it's a well-proven strategy that if you start up your mine with the highest grade possible, and this is often targeted, you have a more successful economic result. Because during startups and ramp-ups, it's the most critical time for projects to find their economic legs during the ramp up period. So by having a higher grade deposit to start the project on significantly de-risks the ramp up operations from a financial perspective. So this is why we're so excited, and we actually had a very good market response to that news today.
Fantastic. So what does this mean in terms of the timeline, Tim?
Well, we said in September last year that we will performing a series of optimization studies, and this is actually a part of that work, and that in March we'll set out our new larger scale project plan. We're on track to do that. So in March we'll have defined the way forward for a single go forward position, which is now likely to include the Iron Peak featuring early in the mine life, if not the very start of the mine life. That work is now being run through with our engineers at the moment. From there, we'll have a period of optimization of that single go-forward position to move it to a definitive feasibility study. Now, we'll be clearer on that time frame in the March announcement when we're ready to do that. We're working through those numbers at the moment. So we're actually on track to what we said we would do in September last year.
Thanks, Tim. So just how important is it that this project is in South Australia?
Well, it's actually a really good point, Tom. South Australia is a proven mining jurisdiction, so it's very attractive to regional investors around the Southeast Pacific region, particularly steelmakers. Australia has always been a strong source of iron ore for Southeast Asia. South Australia in particular has improving credentials, particularly when it comes to the decarbonisation agendas. The state has increased its renewable energy footprint from 1% generated to 70% generated in the last 15 years, and is well on track to be 100% renewable energy on the grid within the next few years. What does that mean? Well, we can start up our mine connected to that grid and have a zero carbon footprint in terms of our energy consumption. So that's critical. And then on top of that, the South Australian government has now committed $600 million to what I would call a seed hydrogen energy industry to really demonstrate the technology and establish it in the state and grow from there. Now, hydrogen's used for energy production and storage, but it's also used for direct reduction in the green steelmaking scenario. So South Australia has not only all the magnetite and renewable energy, but will soon have the hydrogen, which is all the ingredients that we need for a green steel industry. So South Australia is actually the place to be.
Understood. Thank you, Tim. I would be interested to know if you could just set out what you think the potential upside for the company is for this.
Well, the reason I was attracted to this and I joined as CEO in August last year was actually the immense scale of the project. And you know, our current shareholders have heard this many times, and we've had many long-term shareholders that have seen this long-term potential and very large scale potential of this deposit. So we currently have now, with this new update, we've now tipped over 6 billion tons of iron ore in the resource categories of indicated and inferred across our tenement packages. That's a massive amount. And this is only a small part of the Braemar iron formation in South Australia that we hope and intend to open up by developing the Razorback project as the first flagship operation. And this Iron Peak deposit now is going to be the key financial way into that due to its high grade.
Understood. And just one final question from me, Tim. Is there anything that you think investors, either current or future, need to understand better about magnetite?
If you're talking about magnetite, the mineral, of course, magnetite's having its day in the sunshine now. Magnetite's been processed for about 150 years globally, but it's certainly been in the shadow of the big expansion of hematite, which is the alternative iron ore mineral, over the last few decades, lower and lower grades of hematite have been processed in coal-burning blast furnace facilities for decades. That now has to shift in a hurry. All of the global steelmakers are now committed to decarbonizing. They can no longer use blast furnaces, which means they can no longer use low-grade iron ores. And this is where magnetite is now having its day in the sunshine. We are already seeing premiums for high-grade iron ores, including magnetite concentrates, going up. But most importantly, we're seeing premiums for direct reduction grade products, which we have just shown with this Iron Peak release that we can produce extremely high premiums already being. In fact, just late last year, they tipped over $100 a ton for direct reduction pallet premiums over and above the current iron ore price, which is around $125 a ton at the moment. So you can see the potential for where this is going and where Magnetite Mines as a company can take this project. And just on when I talk about the 6 billion tons that we already have in resources, in today's announcement, we also produced an announced exploration target. And it was quite a conservative one. And it ranges up to 26 billion tons just in our tenements alone around the Razorback project. So you can start to see the type of scale and longevity that a project will carry once we get it up and running.
Well, the very best of luck to you, Tim, and thank you very much for joining me today on Proactive.
Absolute pleasure, Tom. Thank you very much.